Hey guys, welcome back to the Mr. Maple Show. I'm Matt. Guys, I got another great top five for you here today. I got one of our field leaders here, so one of our top people here at Mr. Maple. He's been with us a while. He knows his plants, but he's famous for a lot of other reasons. I got Jess with me here today.
What's up, guys? Jess here.
So Jess is one of our leaders here at Mr. Maple. He makes sure a lot of the orders go out correctly. We love getting you on this side of the camera. But Jess is also a member of a very awesome band that'll be playing at Open House, the Carolina Drifters. And man, this guy's musically talented. You've played in a lot of bands over the years. You've toured with some amazing people.
Yeah.
Who are some of the people you've played with or toured with or opened for?
I've been extremely fortunate. My father was a musician, Ed Bradley. He introduced me to a lot of different amazing musicians. I've met and played around with Bo Diddley.
Say no more, man. Yeah. That's royalty right there for rock and roll.
I know it. And, George Clinton was a good acquaintance of mine from my hometown. Got to jam with him a couple of times, hang out at his studio, like that. I've opened for bands Fishbone, 311, just a ton of really, really awesome bands that I'm super fortunate, like I said.
We love to brag on our people here. Jess is not only talented here at Mr. Maple, incredibly talented drummer and musician and just all around. Definitely check out the Carolina Drifters. Y'all's new single is out, Gasline.
Yep.
And you can find that on all major...
Yeah, all the major platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, Amazon, everything you can possibly listen to.
We're lucky these guys work for us. They will be playing at Open House, so come see them at Open House this year. That's going to be September 4th, so Labor Day. We're going to be there from 8 to 4. I'm not sure what time the band's setting up yet, but we're going to have them there playing and a food truck. Heck of a time. Let's get into your top five Japanese maples. Number five, what do you got?
Number five. So number five on my list, and I'm assuming we're going from bottom to top. So number five is going to be the Sumigaki.
Ooh, yeah, nice one, nice one. Yeah, what do you like about Sumigaki?
I really like the simplicity of it, the green, and then it gets those red tips on the
right,
just on the edges. I just think it's such a simple but beautiful.
Oh,
beautiful
it's a tree. Funky one. I love in the spring that red nailed look to it. Almost looks like little hands as it cups down on it. Like especially as it's leafing out. Kind of looks like it's reaching out to give you a high five or so. This is a cool tree.
It does. It's one of my favorites. Number four.
All right, number four. What do you got?
Number four, probably the Sango Kaku. I've got one at my house that I bought here 2 years ago, and it shows out every year. Every winter, it's just bright and pink and just beautiful. Good yellow color too, so I just love that one.
Exceptionally heat tolerant.
Yeah.
We really brag on Sango for those winter months. You got that bright red pink spark of color going on when everything's kind of drab in the garden. We get a little snow here in Western North Carolina.
Yeah.
That's when we didn't get any last year, which is weird.
No.
But that's when I get the camera out. I always run to that thing when there's a little bit of snow going on because it looks so cool.
It does.
Fall color's underrated. I mean, it's kind of got that yellow with the splashes of red in it. It's got a lot going on in the fall, too.
Yeah, and even the spring push, you know, it's just vibrant when it pops out.
I feel you. Great choice.
Number three, I'm going to have to go with the Phantom Flame.
Ooh, okay.
I love any kind of variegation. I'm a sucker for variegation.
So this guy pulls all the orders. He sees everything going out, so he's got a good sophisticated list here. I mean, he gets to see how many plants do you think you knew before you started versus now? It's crazy, right?
That's insane.
I mean, you can find anything right now. He has to pretty much pick Tim's brain to know what Tim's thinking where something is all the time. But Phantom Flame, killer choice. Another purple border, too.
Yeah.
Got that funky purple border going on with that reticulation inside of it.
That's right. And, you know, I have a hard time with the top five because I'm in 30 greenhouses every day.
Right.
So I could have a top five for each house. You know,
it depends on which week and what you're picking that week.
That's right. So number two.
All right. Number two, what you got?
So number two, I'm probably going to go with the butterfly.
Ooh. Yeah. Okay.
Again, I'm a sucker for the variegation, but that white with the green, to me, it just pops so loud. I've got it at my house again. It just shows off to me so much. I love it.
I love it. Early spring yield more pink.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, as the summer creeps in, it's more white and like kind of a mint color.
Yeah.
Such a cool subtlety to that one. I even like that color of green it gets. Like, I think it's a funky, lighter green.
It is.
And it really shows out against that creamy white. Giving this one a lot of shade, you can get some like all white plants. I mean, it really glows, but Give it a little protection from the afternoon sun in the hotter regions, but phenomenal plant.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, mine actually had a little bit of solid white leaving this year. Got it in a great spot, like you said. It's full shade in the afternoon. It's just a beautiful tree. It really
phenomenal.
Is.
All right. Yeah.
And number one.
Drum roll, I guess. Number one, what do you got?
So number one, this has been a tough one because I, you know, like I said, I've seen a whole bunch of them, but I'm gonna have to go with the strawberry spring.
Ooh, that's a good choice. Yeah.
I really love the colors on that one.
That one this year has been creeping into so many top five lists.
Really?
A lot of people keep bringing that one up. Yeah. It's climbing the ranks for sure.
It's a good one. It's a good one. So many different colors, and depending on the amount of shade that it gets versus sun, it's just beautiful.
Another one of those new ghosts, Talon Buckholz introduction, got that funky reticulation going on in there. And I mean, so many colors in the early spring. Like, I don't even know what you call that. Like, it's pink, it's red, it's got some oranges and yellows going on.
Yeah.
Mostly pink, mostly strawberry-ish, but I mean, who could really call that a color? It's like every color.
That's right. Yeah, and it does. It's got every color under the rainbow. It's just a cool tree.
Man, thanks for hopping on here to do a top five. We love getting some of our talented people on this side of the camera, and I don't know if we got many more people talented. This guy from leading our teams to playing in bands on the weekends. This guy does it all. He didn't really have much downtime. If he's not here, he's probably playing somewhere.
Or mowing my neighbor's yard. Right. It's constant.
He's always busy. Definitely come see him at Open House, y'all. We will have the Carolina Drifters here in person at Open House. You can come see Jess and Sean and your wife, Kate, who works here sometimes and plays in the band as well.
Yep.
Definitely come see them at Open House. Show them your appreciation. Also, download their single. It's a killer single. They're going to have a whole album dropping soon with the Carolina Drifters.
That's right.
Gasline. Go check it out. You won't regret it.
Thanks.
All right, guys. Take care. God bless, and have a great day.